Our heel up pulse is an abdominal exercise as well as hip flexor and a little bit of those quads also. Set up for this exercise, we're gonna be down on our back, flat on the floor. Those hands can be at our sides here on the floor, or if you wanna make it a little easier, those hands can be right underneath of the hips. Once you've got those hands in position, we're gonna straighten those legs out up overhead, as straight as you can get those legs. If you're somebody who is a little more tight in those hamstrings and those glutes, you may not be able to straighten those legs quite as far. A slight bend in them is gonna be okay, but if you have that ability, try to get those legs as straight as you can. From this position, we're gonna use those abs to lift just our tailbone up off the ground and press those heels straight up towards the ceiling. So nice and high up towards the ceiling, and then we're gonna control it down. We're not gonna let it just drop back down. So again, point those heels up. We're gonna press on up, get that tailbone up off the ground, and then lower it right back to the ground. Control. We're not gonna press up and kind of just drop and let us start ourselves rock. We're gonna control that back down. Another big thing on this movement is we're gonna try to keep those legs up throughout this movement so that we're not gonna be generating momentum. So what I mean by that is I want those legs to stay up. I want to press up and drop straight back down to that starting position. A lot of times I'll see people kind of go like this movement to where those legs are coming down towards the floor each time. And what that's gonna do is that's gonna kind of create that momentum to get yourself back up. It'll be an easier option that you can do if you need to start that way. But eventually I want you to focus on keeping those legs up and not letting them travel back towards the floor on each rep for these ones. So most common mistakes made on this exercise, one, bending those legs too much. So like I said, if you have tight hamstrings and glutes, that's okay. You can bend those legs a little bit, but what I don't wanna see on this movement is I don't wanna see people go like this, pressing those legs up and bending them at the bottom. Again, what that's doing is that's generating that momentum with the legs, and we're not focusing as much on our abs. So keep those legs as straight as you can throughout that movement. Another big mistake I just touched on a second ago is bringing those legs back towards the floor. So swinging on up like this, try to isolate it as best as you can. I want you to eventually progress to where those legs are staying up and you're going straight up, straight down on this movement. The last big mistake made on this one is not focusing on control with the abs. We want to focus on pressing up, controlling it back down. Each time, we don't want to kind of just be rocking back and forth here and not using those abdominal muscles. Remember, ab exercises typically are ones that you're going to go a little slower on, and that's okay because we really want to focus on engaging our core throughout that movement and not cheating and letting other muscle groups take over.